Hello everyone, I'm Kinjal Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Computer Engineering. So here is the part 1 of Chapter 3, Parsing Theory, Lecture 13. So in last lecture, we have started one example of LR0 parsing and performed first step and constructed canonical set of LR0 items. Now in this lecture, we'll construct LR0 parsing table. So before learning the rules to construct LR0 parsing table, we'll see the layout of table. Where table contains two parts, action and goto, where action contains terminal symbol and goto contains non-terminal symbols. And the row represent the item set, means if there are item set from I0 to IN, then the row represent the set 0 to N. And we need to make two entries in the table. First one is for shift and second one is for reduce. So for shift, we'll make the entry S and for reduce, we'll make the entry R. So next, rules to construct LR0 parsing table. So first rule is to construct canonical set of LR0 items for grammar G-. So we have already created item set I0 to I6 for a given grammar. Now, second step is to construct state I from II item set. Means if there are item set I0 to IN, then construct state from 0 to N. Then the parsing actions for state I are determined as follow. So first step, so we need to make two entries in table. First one is for shift and second one is for reduce. So for shift entry, if go to II comma IA equals to IJ, then set action I on A to shift J, where A must be terminal symbol. Means if I equals to 0 and J equals to 1, then go to I0 comma A equals to I1. So here shift J will become S1. So set S1 entry in from I to A. Okay. If I0 comma A equals to I1, then set S1 entry from I to A. Means from 0 to A. Then next rule is for reduce entry. So if there is production A derives alpha dot, means if dot is at the end of right hand side, so our set is final set, then set action I on A to reduce, A derives alpha, where A is terminal symbol. Means if A is terminal symbol and our state is final state, then set R entry from I to A. Then third rule is if S dash derives S dot is in II, then set action I comma dollar to accept. Means if there is entry S dash produce S dot is in only one state, so set that entry as accept from I to dollar. Now third rule is for non-terminal. So as we have seen one rule for terminal symbol, that how to make entry for terminal symbols for shift. Okay. Now we'll see that how to make entry for non-terminals for shift. So if go to II comma A equals to IJ, then go to I comma A equals to J. So for non-terminal symbol, we'll only add J to the action of I comma A. And fourth rule is all entries not defined by rule 2 and 3 are made error. Okay, so there are two entries to be made. First one is shift. So for shift, if A is terminal symbol, then we'll make one entry SJ. And if A is non-terminal symbol, then we'll make entry J only. Then second rule is for reduce. So we'll make the entry of reduce in all the terminal symbols if dot is at the end of the state or our rule. Now here is the example, the set which we have constructed in last lecture, and this is parsing table which contains two part, action and goto. Action contains terminal symbol and goto contains non-terminal symbol. Item set is from 0 to 6, as there are total I6 item set I02 I6. So now we'll start to make entries of shift using GoTo. So here first GoTo is GoTo I0 comma S equals to I1. So we will place 1 from I0 to S. So from I0 to S, we'll place 1. Then second GoTo is I0 comma equals to I2. So we'll place 2 from 0 to A. So from 0 to A, we'll place 2. Then third GoTo. So third GoTo is I0 comma A equals to I3. So we'll place 3 from 0 to A. So we'll place 3 from 0 to A. So from 0 to A, we'll place 3. Now here as A is terminal symbol, so we'll place entry S3. If I0 comma is non-terminal symbol, then we'll directly place the number J, and if our A is terminal symbol, then we'll place shift 3. Now next go to is I0 comma B equals to I4. So here B is terminal symbol, so we'll place S entry in 0 to B. So from 0 to B, we will place S4. So from 0 to B, we'll place S4. Okay, so shift entries using I0 set has been made. Now we'll check for the I1 set. So in I1 set, there is no go to entry to any other state, but as I1 is final set, as S dash device S dot dot is at the end of the right hand side. So as I1 is final state, dot is at the end of the right hand side. So we'll make one accept entry for this state. So rule says that if there is production S dash derives S dot, then make accept entry from $1 to. So from $1 to we'll make accept entry. Okay. Now we'll check for the I2 set. So for I2 set, there is one go to entry is I2 comma A equals to I5. So we'll place 5 from 2 to A. So from 2 to A, we'll place 5 as A is non-terminal symbol. Now here I2 comma A equals to I3. So as A is terminal symbol, so we'll place S3 in I2 comma A. So from 2 to A, will place S3. Now third entry. So third go to is I2 comma B equals to I4. So from 2 to B, we will place S4. From 2 to B, will place S4. Now for I2 shift entries has been made. So now we'll check for the I3 set. So in I3 set, there is go to I3 comma A equals to I6, where A is non-terminal symbol. So we'll place 6 from I3 to A. So we'll place 6 from I3 to A. Now next go to is go to I3 comma A equals to I3. So we'll place S3 from I3 to A. So from 3 to A, we will place S3. Now third go to is go to I3 comma B equals to I4. So we will place S4 from 3 to B. From 3 to B, we have placed S4. Okay, so shift entries in I3 state has been made. Now we'll check for the I4. So from I4, there is no go to another state. So no entries will be made. Then we'll check for the I5 state. So as I5 also has no go to condition, so no entries will be made. Now we'll check for the I6 state. So I6 also does not have any go to condition. So no more shift will be added for this set. Now we want to make the reduce entry in table. So for that, give numbers to each production that S-A is first production. So 1 will be added, then A derives A is second production, so 2 will be added, then A derives B is third production, so 3 will be added. So if we want to reduce S derives A, then we'll place R1 in all terminal symbols. And if we want to reduce A derives A, then we'll place R2 in all the terminal symbols. And if we want to reduce A derives B, then we'll place R3 in all terminal symbols. So first we'll check for the final state. So as in I0, there are no final state in it. Then in I1 is final state, but we have made entries of except for I1 state. Then we'll check for the I2 state, that is there any dot at the end of right hand side. So as there is no dot at the end of right hand side, so I2 is also not final state. Then we'll check for the I3. So is there any production where dot is at the end of right hand side? So there is no production where dot is at the end of right hand side. So I3 is also not final state. Now we'll check for the I4 state. So as A derives B dot, dot is at the end of right hand side. So I4 is final state. So we'll make reduce entry for I4. So A derives B dot is a third production, so we'll place R3. As A derives B dot is third production, so we'll place R3 in all the terminal symbols of 4. So all the terminal symbols of 4. So we'll place R3 in A, in B, and in dollar also. So as our state is in I4, so we'll place R3 in all the terminals of item set 4. Now we'll check for the I5 state. Is I5 state is a final state? So yes, I5 is a final state as dot is at the end of right hand side. So we'll make entry reduce in I5 state. So S derives A is first production, so we'll make R1 entry in all the terminal symbols of I5. So in set I5, we'll make all the entries of R1 in all terminal symbols. So R1 will be placed from 5 to A, R1 will be placed from 5 to B, and R1 will be placed from 5 to dollar. Okay. Now we'll check for the I6 state. That is I6 state final state. So yes, I6 is a final state as dot is at the end of right hand side. So we'll make reduce entry for A derives A dot. So A derives A is second statement. So we'll place R2 in all the terminal symbols of I6. So in item set 6, we'll place R2 in all the terminal symbols. So from 6 to A, R2 will be placed, from 6 to B, R2 will be placed, and from 6 to dollar, R2 will be placed. So we have made entries of shape, reduce, and except in the table. Now, next task is to find that given grammar is LR0 or not. For that, we need to check for the conflicts in parsing table. So there can be two types of conflict in parsing table: shift reduce conflict and reduce conflict. Shift reduce conflict means if there are multiple entries of shift and reduce in single shell, then the conflict is called as a shift reduce conflict. So if in LR0 parsing table there are multiple entries of shift and reduce in single cell, then the grammar is not LR0. Now second conflict is reduce conflict. So if there are multiple entries of reduce in single shell, then the grammar is not LR0. So if shift reduce and reduce entries are in single shell, then the grammar is not LR0. As there are no shift reduce or reduce conflict in this parsing table, so given grammar is LR0. Okay, so this is how we can construct the parsing table. Now, next task is to parse the input string using LR0 parsing table, which we will learn in next lecture. थैंक यू।